The Duck Pond could potentially attract new students to the university and is also an area for family and friends to gather. We as students want to help make the Duck Pond a better place by adding recycling bins, adding new benches, improving old ones, creating a trail, and fixing hazardous areas around the Duck Pond.
We can do this by having clubs and organizations around campus come together and fundraise for the improvement of the Duck Pond. This could be an annual competition around campus, and the winner would get to adopt the Duck Pond as their area for any events they want to hold there.
Bread bags after bread bags?
Just cups. This is not meant for to be a trash can, right? I didn't think so. They pulled the board up.
Lazy Americans. Please don't attack me, little ducky. He's saying that it's too polluted. How do you feel about this area?
I'm an environmental engineering major at the University of Oklahoma, and I've come here to show you a closer look at the Duck Pond. As we walk through here, the camera might not show up, but there's debris and all sorts of kinds of trash through here. It could be hazardous to families and ducks alike. As we keep on walking down, you see in the water, like this, just floating in the water, which could be not an environmental hazard. We've shown documentaries of families that bring their children here who say that they won't get in the water, and that's just a problem. So what can OU do to fix this problem? Well, first of all, we can clean up the trash around here, and we could take studies of the water quality. Talking to biology students, they said they've grown E. coli cultures in this water. This is the University of Oklahoma, and there's trash everywhere.
I'm here with Emery Smith, environmental engineer from OU. Emery,
how do you feel about the duck pond?
I feel like it can be improved a lot. It's pretty dirty and pretty disgusting. But I still go there often.
How often do you go?
Probably about 3 times a week. I walk my dog there pretty regularly.
Do you let your dog get in the water?
Oh, no. No, it's pretty gross.
Did you know there's E. coli growing in the pond?
No. I did not know that.
Yeah.
I did not. That's really gross, though. Good thing I'm not letting them in the water.
Oh, thanks, Anne-Marie.
No problem.
I'm here with Environmental Club, Our Earth President, Becky Wood. Becky, how often does Our Earth group go to the duck pond?
Well, once a semester, we try to organize an Our Earth trip to the duck pond to clean it up. We wade out into the middle of the duck pond and we clean up litter. We make it a big event. We always have free box lunches for everyone. We try to get community members involved. That's about once a semester. But then individual Our Earth members go and visit the duck pond and help clean it up, usually about once every week. There are always plastic bags in the pond that threaten the wildlife. There are old Coke cans. One time we found Coke cans in there from the 1970s. They were that old. The trash cans are always overflowing. People are never recycling. There are always, you know, Walmart bags and Pepsi cans and paper from old homeworks and things like that all around the duck pond, in the water, in the mud, destroying the wildlife. So I wish that it were.
If you could ask OU to change one thing about the duck pond, you as an individual, what would you want them to change?
I want them to take more ownership of the duck pond, to really take responsibility for cleaning it up. Right now, I think they empty the trash cans about once every weekend, and that's obviously not enough. If they could just increase it to emptying the trash cans maybe once every couple days, or implementing recycling at the duck pond, that would make a huge difference. It would reduce the amount of trash in the pond, because it wouldn't have time to blow into the pond and disturb the wildlife.
And taking off, like, say that this does happen, but taking stress off OU and the budget and money that they would have to go into people going in and cleaning, and the stress off our Earth taking responsibility and cleaning the duck pond, would you support a program in which sororities or fraternities and clubs would actually compete against each other to, say, adopt the duck pond and be able to clean it up?
Definitely. I think that that's definitely the route to go. Right now, there's a really successful program at OU called Adopt an Area, and that's been really successful for sororities and fraternities and housing centers and other clubs to get really invested in a project and have ownership of a specific part of OU to keep that clean. So I think if we involve the duck pond in that, that would be a perfect way to increase student involvement, to improve the environment, and to alleviate the stress on university resources.
We want you.
We want you.
We want you.